Hi everyone, welcome to this seminar. Today I'm going to talk about
update
images by digging out and automatically fixing the vulnerabilities. This topic was actually originated from communities. A lot of community users, when they are using Harbor, they really like the scan imaging feature from Harbor. However, that will generate some results with some issues. How do I restore my image or how do I update my image after I get a result? And today I'm going to explain that. This speech will be delivered by me and my colleague, Rulin. He is the DaoCloud DevOps architect, and I am also from VMware. Well, I'm the Harbor maintainer. To deliver this topic, this was actually Rulin's idea, and he would like to make some contribution to answer the questions from communities. Firstly, we'd like to talk about some of the background knowledges. Firstly, what is CVE? CVE is Common Vulnerability Exposures, which means this is a public disclosed cybersecurity vulnerabilities and exposures. It can be seen as a dictionary, and all of the cyber security vulnerabilities and exposures are publicly disclosed. Whenever there is a new vulnerabilities or exposure got captured, and that vulnerability or exposure will get into CVE. And once it enters the CVE dictionary, it will provide you with your ID. And you can see the format of CVE. It has a CVE with the time of, with the year when the vulnerability was identified. Why we this is a four-digit serial number. I will explain later. And NVD is a National Vulnerability Database. It is a database based on CVE. And this is actually an expansion of CVE. It provides enhanced information for each entry. Let's look at this graph. This is the total CVE entries over the past few years. You can see, especially recently, since 2017, the vulnerabilities identified each year was already beyond 10,000. Before 2017, each year we only identified 7,000 vulnerabilities. However, after 2017, we identified 10,000 of vulnerabilities each year, which means every 30 seconds, you might be able to identify a new vulnerability, which means after this session, you might be called back to your office to restore the vulnerability, a new vulnerability. I'm not sure whether you've attended this morning's session, the keynote speech I delivered. I talked about the Linux, one of the Linux master talked about the Linux latest RC4 delays by security issue. And then also another Linux master talked that in since 2016 to 2018, there are more than 1,000 CVEs assigned to kernel. You can see that security is of great significance currently. Let's talk about image security. The biggest advantage of image is its immutability, and that ensures its consistence, which means from testing, development, to distribution to the client, I can ensure the consistence of the image via binary. However, this kind of immutability also has its disadvantages. If the original image has some vulnerabilities, you can see from this diagram that all of the users around the globe will be exposed to the vulnerability. Therefore, your development cost will be really high because you have to restore all of the vulnerabilities across the world by each user. Now that security is such an important issue, what can we do? I'm sure you all traveled with subway before, and you can see the security gate in the convention center before you enter. You can see that they didn't actually unpack your luggage. However, they can identify or scan any illegal stuff just by scanning your luggage. Here, image security can also use the same method. You can also have static scan of the image to see whether the image has some CVE. This diagram shows Harbor, one of the scan results from Harbor. You can see after scanning on an image, you can see all of the information associated with this scan of this image. And then finally, you will also have a result to see how vulnerable is or how risky is the vulnerability. Now I'd like to talk about topology of the static scan. Firstly, the Harbor will trigger a scan task, and then the job will be dispatched to job service. And then job service will do the job scan, which is static scan. And then we use a tool called quarry. Quarry is an open source static scan tool. And then in Harbor job, firstly Harbor trigger a scan, and then Roger will get all of the layer information of the image. You know, the information includes layer and manifest. So firstly, you need to put all of the layers, and then the layers will be posted to Claire. And based on the CVE source, the data gathered from CVE source, Claire will conduct the scan. Claire will be connected to a CVE database. And these databases come from four sources, which are Debian, Ubuntu, Red Hat, and Oracle. And these sources are updated real time because CVE will be growing each day. Every day we will identify new CVE. Therefore, the sources are updated real time every day. Job will realize this circle and push all of the layer from Harbor to Claire for scan. And then Harbor will get the result from Claire and then summarize the result. And then you will know how many was the priority of each CVE. And then what kind of result it is for each image. In terms of scan Harbor also has another feature, which is policy control. Now that we've already scanned and get a scan result, how do we utilize the scan result in Harbor? In Harbor code, we add some inspector. When Docker initiate pull request, when the request haven't entered register, we will capture the request. And then if I need to check, and I need to check whether there are some high priority vulnerability in it, and I also have set a rule, if there is high priority vulnerability, then the rule will not be applied. That means the request will be rejected. That means no one can use image that has high priority vulnerability. You have to restore the vulnerability first, and that will ensure that the Docker image delivered to the end user does not contain any high priority vulnerabilities. And for image scan, what does Harbor do next? Firstly, webhook. Every time I scan an image successfully, I will post the result to the webhook. And then you can get all of the information of the image. And then second,
whitelist.
So you can set up your own whitelist, which means these are the vulnerabilities that the image doesn't care. For example, there are some of the images are only for test, and test images doesn't really care so much about the vulnerabilities. The priority are not so high. Otherwise, the rest of the images should have policy check. And then if Harbor wants to expand third-party scanner, currently Harbor only support Claire. And now we would like to partner with Anchor. Currently Anchor engineer are partnering with Harbor and want to establish connection with Anchor so that we can provide a pluggable server for end users. And the end users will have more options in the third-party scanners. You can have both Claire, Anchor, Trevor, or Micro scanners scan result. I know some of the users use their own scan mechanism. So if we have already defined the interface, the user can also use their own scanner to connect with the interface and then use their own scanner result. Next, Ruling is going to talk about how can we resolve the vulnerability once we identify some. Thank you for attending this seminar. Previously, we talked about after we identify the vulnerability, how can we restore the vulnerability? And in the setting, we identify the vulnerability if the vulnerability is high level or high priority vulnerability, then the system will stop the user from downloading the image. However, the business might continue. How do we restore the vulnerability to ensure the consistency of the business? This was our previous need. And we basically still use Harbor based on its clear auto-scanning mechanism. And then we wrote an external program to check the image of the vulnerability as well as the priority of the vulnerability. It also includes the number and label of the vulnerability, and to see whether it has any restored software package. If we do have it, then we will redefine the image. This is a very simple process. Firstly, you have auto scan, and then the level of the vulnerability, auto restore, and the confirmation of the scan. That will mean that the vulnerability has been restored. Claire is a open source vulnerability analysis tool by CoreOS, and the data basically come from CVE and some of the other database. Since 1.2 version in 2017, Java started to have to support the embedded query to have vulnerability scan, and in the current version we have it supports all kinds of strategies. For example, if the vulnerability is high priority, then we can stop the user from downloading the image. The level of the vulnerability includes severe, medium, low, and ignorable. Severe means that we don't recommend you to continue using it in your production environment. However, you can still use it in the test in the QA environment. And for the medium level, you can wait and see. And for the if you are using some basic infrastructure, then you need to really attach great importance to the vulnerability and think about how to deal with it. Before restore the vulnerability, you need to have some preparation. For example, currently Java already supports the construction of the history. For example, when you construct the image, you can use the Dockerfile order that will be gathered in Docker, and you can use this history in the future. And then second, you need to think about how to determine the basic image system, and that will be very relevant to what kind of order you need to use in order to restore it. For example, you might use some YAML update. And if it is Alpine, then you might need to use APK or upgrade. So currently, we still need to use Dockerfile. We need to use it to determine what kind of basic image it is and what kind of part should be updated. In practice, we also need to determine whether the image is allowed to update. Some of the package will have the requirement on the version. If you update it, you might also update the whole version, and that will not be so user-friendly, which means we need to determine whether the image is allowed to update. And then also the vulnerability component has already got its restored version. And then later you also need to call Docker build and then repush. We need to capture all of the images, filter out the images that has high-level vulnerabilities, or the level is beyond your setting. And then you need to deal with those vulnerabilities. check the information of the vulnerability, determine whether it has already got some restored version. And then you need to generate a report to see what kind of vulnerabilities has already been restored.
So that we can identify the version of this image. We should think about whether we just do the system updating or the third party software packages updating. So we must think about this simultaneous updating job. And last but not least, we must call the API to check this recovered image to see whether it is recovered or not. If there is other vulnerabilities, we will do this scanning within this cycle. I mean, keep scanning,
recovering
this vulnerability. We use this external program to call this Harbor API to finish it. And this program has been delayed for almost 1 year. And I believe that in the future, within 1 week, we will release an external API port version. And we can make it into or include it into the Harbor. Unless it discusses or some triggering system mechanism to implement it. But now we have some dependencies. Let's say this fundamental or basic image dependency problems. So that's all for my presentation. Thank you. Any questions? For the image recovering, for those images that have been pushed, how do you deal with them? For those pushed images, we haven't had this handling or processing. It should be determined by your user scenarios. Thank you. Please use turn on the microphone, otherwise interpreter cannot interpret. Please use the microphone, turn on the microphone. You mean the signature? What kind of signature? You mean use the CBD database? Software? No microphone, no interpreting. In terms of scanning, the Harbor is responsible for pushing it into this layer. I don't know. I don't understand your question. What do you mean by the signature? If it's about version or edition, the CBD database will identify the vulnerabilities. So there will be a lot of all kinds of software versions, and it will know all the software packages within your software. It will just capture the version for you. Because it's a static scanning. Thank you. For your project, from the scanning to the result, or to this policy filtering, and I think it's okay, but for this auto recovery, after recovery, there will be a rescanning. If there is vulnerabilities, and it will continue the scanning. But maybe this recovery will see a failure. If there is failure, how do you handle it?
If
there is a failure, it will repeat three times. If there is a failure, and it will be just showing within the report, so there should be some human intervention in this case. I know that. But in terms of this recovery, I believe there are a lot of things that need human intervention. And the software version or this hardware and software dependencies. Let's say if you update one software, but this software rely on other packages, then that depend on other packages. So we know that only one software vulnerability requires several kinds of software package updating. So in this case, I believe the human intervention is a must in this case. And I think that this will repeat three times. Three times will be this maximum. So for the whole recovery, and I believe there will be very possible to see many failures. In terms of vulnerabilities, if you do the scanning, and we know that it is static image, but for many vulnerabilities, they should be handled within the operation. I know, I mean that whether this vulnerability is useful or if it is not worth it, I don't think we should recover it. So it, I believe that we must know that whether this image is useful or not. So it means that it still requires human intervention based on scanning result. Based on the scan result, so there should be this human intervention to determine whether you need this recovery, am I right? Please use a microphone, otherwise the interpreter cannot interpret. Another question. Now you use the scanner. Is clear? Yes. And I believe you will use more scanners. If we use clear or other type of scanner to do the scanning, and it will, maybe we will get different results. How do you handle this situation or scenario? Okay, some companies doesn't trust a third-party open source tool. Some companies just rely or trust their own tools. They just rely on their own scanner result. That's why we do it in this way. Thank you. Yes, we can do this limitation. The challenge is that without breaking the original commands, we just update these software packages that should see this updating. For this system software packages, because we know that it's static scanning. For your code scanning, should be done in your inside your programs instead of the other channels. And I believe that. You give me the boundary. In terms of Docker image, if you just give me the gold boundary, I cannot scan in this way. I scan the source code. So the source code scanning must be done in your own CI. Any questions? Okay, thank you. That's all for my presentation. Thank you all for joining us. Thank you.